Hey everyone, my name is Josh Wood and I work with the Family Ministries here at First Baptist Church in Fernandina Beach. And I just want to thank you for joining us this week as we take some time each day to spend time in prayer. You know, God says that He honors the person who disciplines themselves to pray. And as our kids go back to school and as our teachers go back to school and our community prepares for this school year, I can't think of a better thing for us to do than to be in prayer for them throughout the year. And so this week, we're devoting separate, specific times each day to pray for them. Before we jump into our prayer today, I want to kind of talk about what we're going to pray about. Today, we're praying for students. All the students, whether they're going into preschool or there are high school graduates going off to college, we want to be praying for our students and for God to work with them and to bless them, to keep them safe, to prosper them in their studies and their relationships and their encounters. And also this year, we want to pray that He will keep them healthy and He'll keep them safe from all the different stresses and all the different things going on in our country, in our community. And it's going to be happening in our schools. And that's where our children are going to be. And so that's why we want to pray for them. We also want to pray for those that are learning from home, whether it's through virtual schools or it's through a hybrid system, or even if there's people out there that are homeschooling and choosing to homeschool for the first time. We know that we have some incredible homeschool veterans in our community, and there's also going to be quite a few doing it for the very first time this year, and we want to be praying for all of you as well. Before I jump into praying for our students, I want to read off a list of our schools in our county so that we can be thinking of them. And as you hear these schools, just say a quick prayer and pray for that school. Pray for the students that are at that school, and just pray for God's leading and God's blessing for them this year. So these are the schools that we're praying for. We're praying for Fernandina Beach High School, Fernandina Beach Middle School, Emma Love Hardy Elementary, Southside Elementary, Yulee Middle School, Yulee High School, Yulee Elementary School, and Yulee Primary School. We're thinking about Fernandina Beach Christian Academy, Callahan Elementary School, Bryceville Elementary School, West Nassau High School, Wildlight Elementary, Callahan Middle School, Hilliard Elementary School, Callahan Intermediate School, Hilliard Middle Senior High, Faith Christian Academy, Amelia Island Montessori, St. Michael's Academy, and many, many others. If I didn't mention your school, I apologize for not getting to it, but just know we are praying for your students. So let's pray together. Father, we come to you. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your goodness. God, we want to pray for the students who are going to be going to school this year, who are going into these hallways and into these classrooms. Many of them, it's a very familiar place, but it's going to feel so distant. God, I remember just months ago as they were leaving those schools, heading out for spring break, not knowing that all of this was going to happen. God, for many of them, as they step back into those buildings for the very first time, it could be a very emotional experience. And so, God, we pray that you would lead them, that you would bless them, that you would comfort them. God, we pray that you would protect them. God, go before them and use your incredible power to create a safe, comfortable environment for our children to learn. God, we want to pray against anxiety. We want to pray against fear. We want to pray against sickness. God, we want to pray against anything that would cause harm or cause our young ones to worry or to be fearful. God, we know that each of our students is an individual person, an individual soul that matters to you. And so we call on you now to care for your children, to care for our children, to care for these little ones, these souls, that you would just cherish them and hold them close. God, I think of those students going into high school. God, it has been such an incredible experience for them coming up through the grades. And now as they're in high school and they're preparing to set their trajectory for the rest of their lives, God, that you would just give them an opportunity to learn in a safe environment. God, that you would give them great relationships and incredible learning opportunities. God, that you would keep the things from them that would be distractions. God, you would take the enemy's desire to destroy and to kill. And you would cast that aside, and God just set before them an incredible path to experience the best school year possible. God, we want to think about our middle school students. there's so much change, there's so much transition going on in middle school, just within their bodies alone, let alone thinking about having to change classrooms and having to keep track of what subjects are on what days and how to focus in on those studies, all along with the social pressures and the relational pressures that come with growing up. God, we pray for these young students. We thank you for their passion and their energy. God, sometimes it feels like that energy can be overflowing, but we thank you for it. We pray that you would use it and you would wield it for your kingdom and for your power. God, show them that they are not alone. Even though they may feel it at sometimes, God, I pray that every child, every student will know that they are loved and they are cared for. God, we think about our elementary students. Many of these kids can't even understand what's happening around them. They don't even grasp the things going on in this world. But they know that it's not quite right, and they know that it doesn't feel like it felt before. God, we just pray that you give them an incredible portion of grace and understanding. God, help them to feel that they are loved, that they are needed, that they are cherished. God, I pray that you would continue to meet them where they're at, answer their questions about this great big world. Help them to feel as though they are important. Because God, we know that you cherish these young ones, and they are some of your fondest creations. God, ultimately, we pray for all of our children going back to school, whether they're homeschooled, public school, private school, virtual school, hybrid, whatever the situation is, God, that you will just be there and you will love them and you will cherish them. And God, you will meet their every need. Father, we thank you for the gift that children are to our lives. God, we thank you for the opportunity to lead them and to guide them and to instruct them. God, I thank you for the opportunities of meeting them through their parents, through virtual platforms. God, thank you for the opportunity to lead and instruct and guide these children. God, I want to just pray right now that as we go about our busy days and we have to worry about the things that we focus on, that we would just set aside a period of time to pray to you, to pray for these students, to pray for our teenagers. God, to pray for our young adults. I think of the class of 2020 who is now preparing for the workforce, or they're preparing for college. God, that you will bless them and equip them and use them in an incredible way. God, ultimately we know that you will and you are using this whole situation for your good, to build your kingdom. We pray against the enemy. We pray against his desire to use this to topple families and to topple children's identities and teenagers' self-esteem. But God, that you would come alongside and that you would build them up. God, thank you for this incredible community. Nassau County is truly a special place, and mostly because of the people that are in it and because of the God that we serve. And so, God, we thank you for that. God, we pray all these things in your Son, Jesus' name, who came to this earth, lived this life, saw the pain, and one day went to the cross and felt that pain. He bore our sin. He died our death. He was buried, but 3 days later, he rose again, conquering sin, death, and hell itself. And through him and our faith in him, we as well can conquer it with him. So God, I thank you for your Son. It's in his name that we pray all these things. Amen. Well, hey guys, thank you so much for joining us in prayer today. We will be here again tomorrow and each day this week, Monday through Friday, praying for our schools, praying for specific things. Today we prayed for students. I want to encourage you to continue praying for students today. Every time you think about it, just throw a prayer up. God hears you. It makes a difference. If you have a student in your family or influence over a student, reach out to them and let them know that you're praying for them. Let them know today that you are specifically praying for them by name. It'll make a difference. It might even change their lives. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you tomorrow. God bless.